While the rest of the world's been transfixed by earthly military matters, Peter Dutton's had his eyes on the sky and beyond.
It's my great pleasure today to officially announce the stand-up of Australia's Defence Space Command with a view to protecting our national interests and our need for a space force in the future. Pew, pew, pew.
Space Command will be headed up by Air Vice Marshal Cath Roberts, with Space Force eventually to sit alongside the Army, Navy and Air Force as our fourth military branch. Sort of like a mini-me to America's 6,000-plus Space Force.
He's my special boy!
Space is becoming more congested and is already contested.
And money will be invested so Australia isn't bested.
This conference is designed to force us to step back and to examine not just the tip of the spear, but the whole spear, without which the tip really has limited use.
Now, you're probably wondering,
what is the right size, shape and composition?
I don't know, sir, but it looks like a giant
spear. It is essential to realise that the true value of the spear lies in the person that's wielding it. This is what makes the spear useful.
Wow.
Okay, so heavy on the spear chat, but light on details. Still, space is getting spicy. Both Russia and China are developing hypersonic missiles believed to be capable of shooting our satellites out of orbit. And the Defence Minister reckons it's time we got our act together.
We know that some countries are developing capabilities to threaten or degrade space networks. Countries that see space as a territory for their taking rather than one shared.
And that calls for a splashy defence announcement. In fact, there's an election coming up. Just a coincidence, I guess.
So what's it going to be? You going to sit there like an idiot doing nothing? Or are you going to join Space Force?
Is this just an election announceable or is that too cynical?
It is a positive announcement in that space is the new frontier, technologically speaking, with defence, communications, weather, satellites. It really is important. And let's face it, the US and China and Russia have very sophisticated space programs. But I wouldn't be holding my breath for a launch facility capability in Australia anytime soon. We're not going to see our defence force being propelled into space just yet.
Would you go into space?
Would I?
Sorry. Yeah.
Well, I'd want to go with Elon Musk and SpaceX.
Okay.
I think that would be... Maybe that's what's going to happen. The government will build the facility,
right,
and it could be used by the Defence Force, but, of course, the private sector, the Elon Musks of the world could use it.
You've become very private sector since you left government, haven't you?
Haven't I?
Oh, dear.
Yeah.